Mammoth School meeting at 7:01. First order of business is reorganization. Do I hear nominations for chair?
I nominate Elaine Campbell for chair.
Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a first and second. Any other nominations? Hearing none, closing nominations. All those in favor of Elaine for chair? I have to do a roll call vote. Michael?
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
Was Phil on? Didn't see him. And Jared's not on. So actually, Elaine, you have to vote for yourself in order to.
All righty, I'll vote for myself.
All right.
That's important.
I hand the meeting over to you.
All righty. So now we need nominations for vice chair.
Kristen, are you talking? We can't hear you.
I'm sorry.
I'll nominate Michael.
I'll second that.
All right. And roll call vote. Denise?
Yes.
Michael?
I'll vote for myself, yes.
All right. And I will vote for you also. Secretary?
I think I'm listed as a secretary.
I think you are.
I'll nominate Denise to continue on as secretary.
I'll second that. Roll call. Michael?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Denise?
Yes.
Look at, we're all full of ourselves. There we go. And we need a frontier rep. Does anybody, Phil's been doing it. Is there any other interest? All righty. I'll nominate Phil.
I'll second that.
All right. Roll call. Michael?
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
And I'll vote for Phil also. And member, that's to union, that's to frontier also.
So the rest are appointees. You get to just wield the power of chair.
All righty.
You can ask, obviously, but you get the point.
Now, isn't Jared already a member at Frontier? He got voted onto the committee?
Correct. So technically, you guys should not use Phil because Phil is not a member of Frontier. So he gets a vote at 38. You actually, all five of you, the way it's set up, get a vote. So I would recommend that it's Michael, Elaine, and Denise on the 38. That way all five of you get a vote because Jared is acting at large and we'll get a vote on Frontier, and Phil is the appointed at Frontier, so he'll get a vote at Frontier should
there be a meeting. All right. So I appoint Michael, Denise, and myself. Awesome. Is that all we need?
No, you need a collaborative rep.
Oh, yeah. You willing to do it again, Denise?
I am. I'm on their finance committee and policy committee. So they're in need. Yeah. So I'll hold that down.
It's a cool.
They need people. Yeah.
All right. So I appoint Denise?
Yep.
All right. Anything else?
You need to technically you have to have people on these ones. So the negotiations team, it's not negotiation year. You can just stay on it. You're on it currently.
Yep.
Policy review subcommittee, Phil is on it. We haven't used it, but we might use it with some of the anti-racism equity stuff.
He loves that. He can stay on that.
And then you guys appointed Phil last committee meeting to their regionalization subcommittee. So
yeah,
technically you can just reassign.
I'll reassign. Awesome. All right.
That is
all. Righty. So we're all reorganized or same organized for another year. And so review and approval. Can I have a motion, any changes or anything for the minutes of May 17th or motions to approve?
A motion to approve the minutes of May 17th.
Great.
And I will second.
And roll. Do we have to roll call for that? No, we don't. We don't need a vote on that, do we? Do we roll call that? All right.
Yeah, technically.
Denise.
Yes.
And I vote yes also.
Yes.
All right. Financial statements.
Hello.
Hi there.
I sent out the expense reports. There were 12 warrants signed electronically since last meeting. The total on that was $67,630.42. There's currently, on the report that you all have, I believe it shows about 95,000 roughly available in budget to spend through the end of the year. That's actually been updated, you know, because that's only through May 31st. So even going out just a few more weeks, we have spent down some of that on regular bills. And Kristen has been doing a good job buying additional educational supplies, materials, and equipment. Because we have had some savings in certain lines. A couple of examples include our substitute line, we did not fully expend. Our professional development line, the teachers did not fully take advantage of that line there. We had some personnel changes that generated some savings throughout the year. So Kristen and I have been in conversation about spending down that thing, that money on things such as, you know, wish list kind of items, things that the school normally wouldn't buy, but at this time of year, we have those funds available. So I know you all love for her to spend some money, so I thought you'd want to hear that. So at this point, I think we have about 67,000 left in the budget to spend between now and June 30th. Some of that will naturally get spent because there's some stipends not posted yet. There's utility bills not posted yet for June, that kind of thing. I am in conversation with Kristen about another small order. So we're working on spending that down. And the recommendation is that any balance remaining be reclassified to school choice before the end of the year. And that's typical practice. We'll try to get that down as much as we can with regular bills so that we're not holding on to too much excess budget funds. My guess is we're probably going to be reclassifying about $30,000, which is pretty typical at this time of year. So I'm happy to take other questions if you have them, but that's all I have to report on right now. And I will have an update come September on revolving funds once we have end of year balances and reconciliations complete.
I think that's a pretty amazing job budgeting with all the unknowns of the year, isn't it? I think that's remarkable.
I'm surprised that we didn't use all of our substitute teachers, given all of the sickness and everything happening.
Yeah, I think Kristen's had to be pretty creative in how classrooms are being covered and, yeah. You know, being mindful still of who's coming in and out of the building and things like that. But all the schools have done a great job this year.
Awesome. Any questions on the financial statements?
Chris, I'm assuming that teachers have a wish list that they provide you from time to time.
We sure do. And every time Shelley says something, we start knocking some things off of that, and they're very happy.
Yeah.
We like happy teachers.
Yeah.
It's great.
Hey, we're done with Shelley, so I'm going to excuse her if anybody has any more financial questions.
She's got to go walk her dog.
She's got to go walk her dog.
I'm free.
Thanks.
Have a great summer. See you guys in the fall.
Doing such a great job. We'll see
you. Thank you.
Hope you get some time off.
Thanks. Thanks, Darius.
Bye. Principal's report. Kristen sent us a principal's report.
Elaine, I stumbled a little in the minutes. Can I go back for a minute and ask a couple questions? Okay, thank you. I usually don't, but it was kind of fast. Oh, no. Oh, my.
Welcome.
Okay. So if you don't mind, the appointments, Phil Cantor is the Frontier Regional School Committee representative. Is that correct?
Yes.
And then the Union 38 representatives, was it?
Michael, Denise, and myself.
Okay, great. Got that. Denise, the collaborative.
Yep.
And then as representative of the negotiation team, is it you and Phil, Elaine?
Yes.
Just Elaine.
Oh, just me.
Just one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, just me.
And Phil is the policy review subcommittee, correct?
Correct.
Okay, great. So I gave everyone the principal report, our school improvement plan. You know, I was telling Darius the other day, the school improvement plan is really great. You know, we work hard on the plan at the beginning, and then it's a great roadmap for us throughout the year. And although we'll continue to work, some of those things are ongoing. I can happily say that we sort of checked all those boxes. So it's a great working document. We have 32 students registered for the Conway Grammar School Summer Program. You know, you allowed us to do that after my first year here. Not a lot of the students were attending Deerfield, so I came to you with a request to have our own summer program. So we went from 2 kids attending Deerfield to now look at us all these years later, and we have 32 kids coming, which is
really awesome.
So thank you for that. And then we were able to get back to a lot of our end of the year end of the year events, as I listed. You know, parents are in the community are so happy to get out. Our preschool graduation, we had 19 students, and we ended up with 64 family members. It was outside.
Oh my God, that's awesome.
And then, as Denise knows, our Conway sixth grade graduation, we put out 120 chairs, and we had to get 50 more. We had about 170 people
there. Wow.
It was fabulous. Parents and grandparents and aunts and uncles and all the little siblings running around. So we were so excited to end the year that way. Really looking forward to getting people back to the school.
So, Denise, you're done with Conway Grammar.
I'm no longer a child at Conway Grammar.
Don't leave us.
I know. Yeah. It's so sad. It's exciting, but sad. Yeah.
So well, there were kids on Monday crying on the bus on the way home.
We all started sobbing. we do this thing where we all go outside and wave. And we had kids crying, and then we're all crying. And, you know.
I said to Maddie as she was leaving, I'm like, you can be okay. This could be an emotional day. Yeah, she was looking forward to the treats. So
yeah, good.
That's good.
So we ended on a real high. It was great. Yeah. Thank you.
That's awesome. That's great. I do not think we have any questions for Kristen. Just another great year, Kristen, and thank you for your leadership through these crazy times and to come out the other end looking, you know, with happy kids, happy parents. It's quite an accomplishment. So. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you, all of you. Thank you very much.
I do not think we had public comment, not that I saw. And we're on to unfinished business. And we have votes on things that we had first read of or have read. So take one at a time, Darius.
You know, other committees have just voted them as... like MASC updates to Section A, just vote it just like that.
Okay. Can we have a vote on MASC policy update Section A? Can I have a motion?
A motion.
Second?
I'll second it.
And a roll call vote. That's my dog pukes in the background. Denise?
Yes.
Michael?
Yes.
Phil?
Yes.
All righty. And I vote yes also. Policy Section J updates. That was the very long one that we got, right?
It was the one you got some updates on where the nurses changed some minor language.
Yeah.
But yes. So from the first read, there was some minor language change, but nothing, you know, some detailed kind of things, not a month's time issue.
Right. Can I have a motion on Policy Section J updates? On MSA, MAS.
Yeah.
Bill, motion. Second?
I'll second.
Second.
All right. And roll call. Phil?
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
Michael?
Yes.
And myself. Now, foundation statement on anti-racism and equity. Any discussion? Motion.
Yes. I'll make a motion.
All right. Second. And roll call. Michael?
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
Bill? I'll take that as a yes. And I will vote yes also. Resolution in support of the Fair Share Amendment that also went through town meeting. Can I have a motion?
Yeah.
Second?
I'll second it.
And roll call. Phil?
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
Michael?
Yes.
And I will... vote in support of that also. and superintendent's evaluation summary. That was sent to us, and we need to vote in support of that. Can I have a motion?
A motion.
Second?
I'll second it.
And call Denise. Denise, roll call, yes.
Yes.
Michael?
Yes.
Bill?
I hope I'm voting to say that he's exemplary and or excellent. I don't quite know what I'm voting on, but if it says he's excellent and incredible and amazing, then yes, I'm that.
Oh, you're just sucking up now. I'll vote not. You guys did summary? I'll vote in support
of
you too.
I'm sure I did. It's not ringing a bell right now, but I'm sure I did.
Okay. Alrighty, that is all our unfinished business. And yes, Darius, I mean, I appreciate all your leadership through this crazy year. And I hope you get a lot of rest this summer. That was something else. Mask, no mask, in school, out of school, happy people, unhappy people. Oh my God. Crazy. We had limited superintendents out there in the world anyway, and if a pandemic doesn't make that pool a lot smaller anyway, we feel lucky to have you.
Yep, thank you. Thank you for the evaluation.
Yeah. And new business, DESE COVID testing update.
So basically, I did send you the memorandum that came out from DESE that basically explained what they're doing with testing moving forward. They did provide... We already have them in hand testing for the summer. Kids to be sent home with families and symptomatic testing at school. And then next fall, they are not providing tests, but recommend that you do symptomatic testing. So it's a few months away, we'll be able to figure out where it's at, but we will have enough left over from the summer testing to get us probably through September or close there to symptomatic testing. And so, I did write in my superintendent's report, kind of explain that the companies have kind of cornered the market, and the only way you can buy it is in extreme bulk, unless you're going to pay $20 a box. The box has two tests in it. Buy in big bulk is $10 a box. But we're working with other superintendents to talk about doing some bulk ordering, perhaps through the collaborative, or one of the bigger districts has offered to maybe work as a housing to take in, spend the $75,000 on tests and then deliver, provide those tests to other orders. So we're working on those kind of things, but I also don't know where COVID will be. The state's moving away from, the schools being a testing for symptomatic. It's a big debate we can have. I think sure everybody's having it in their homes and whatnot about, what we're seeing symptomatic wise and as it ripped through Conway, what was it, what did it really do with families and that kind of stuff? Being that the most recent strain has been pretty mild. But I think we probably will end up starting the school year off with doing some testing, and then we'll see where it goes from there. But there's going to be a whole new re-registration process. They're going to make us jump through all those kind of hoops. So it'll be interesting to see how, what that looks like as, this new year comes. But I just want to keep people apprised with where the state's headed with this.
Are we going to do anything with getting younger kids vaccinated? Any drives or anything?
So there will be more drives coming out of Deerfield's kind of taking the lead community on that. They're going to have one, I believe, in August. I'll put a parent square announcement out on that when that comes up. So that's what I want to know of.
Awesome. And any questions about that? Or we had enough of COVID for the year? All right. Edit to the school calendar, spring conferences.
So, what happened? Yeah. So where we put the, spring conferences, is Good Friday was that Friday. And so that's really becomes right now, Good Friday is a school day. So it wasn't raised the red flag when we created the schedule, but the amount of people who, don't celebrate that holiday, but observe that holiday really does impact scheduling when the number of people and teachers that affects. And so I'm asking the committee to move those two half days to the week prior to 31st of March, minor impact on the schedule, actually puts a nice break in that long the long march, you know, the 8 weeks of March kind of deal that some school feels like. So we'll move those dates there. So I'm just looking for approval to do that.
Do we need to vote it?
Yep.
All right. Can I have a motion that we move the spring conferences to the last March 31st?
Thursday and Friday, yep.
30th and 31st.
I'll make a motion to move the half days and adjust the calendar.
All righty. And Phil, was that a second?
Yeah.
All right. And yeah. Dave, Phil?
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
Michael?
Yes.
And I will vote in favor also. I do not have a report. Denise, you sent us a collaborative report.
I did. I sent you the May Executive Director Report and also included that as a brochure, which is pretty awesome that they've just recently put together. But the executive report is highlighting, you know, all the work and achievements that they've had over the year. And they wanted to point out, too, that they do have resources available to support, you know, racism and white supremacy. And so they wanted us to be sure and mention that they do have support for that and anti-discrimination. And they did provide some links to resources in that email as well. But that executive report is going through all of the areas that CES manages, everything from workforce development to professional services, early childhood, et cetera. So, I mean, they're such a dynamic group and they do so much. So it's always hard for me to kind of put in words what is important to our school committee. But please let me know if you want me to follow up on anything or ask any questions, because I meet with them several times a month now. So please do.
That's all. <Wow. awesome. laughs> They also do a great mental health first aid for kids
program. They do so much licensure, professional development. You know, if it's just a lot, and it's really a lot to come into the collaborative and to learn about it.
It really is. So I'm glad you're hanging in there. Usually, like once somebody masters it, it's like then we lose them. So
it takes some time.
That's awesome.
The new director, Todd Goss, seems to really be moving the organization in a really great way. He's really streamlining, and they've reorganized their business office, and they're just making a lot of positive change for the collaborative, and the employees are happy. They've recently negotiated a contract, and it seems like they're in a really good spot. So
that's awesome.
Nice.
Thanks for repping up there. I think that's it for our reports.
Hey, just a quick announcement that to say publicly that Donna Hathaway, after serving the district since 2007, is planning on retiring this summer, and she does so much behind the scenes for the district. I just wanted to say, recognize her tonight and thank her for her service.
Keeps us all moving in the right direction, huh?
Yep.
Are you doing anything for her?
We'll do a celebration for her, retirement party.
All right. Sounds good. Give her our best and thank her for rallying us all together at different times. It's like herding cats. I'm sure her job is.
That's what you should give. I get confused.
Yeah, you should give her like a cat herding award or something. All righty. Any other business? I think that's a record.
I won the bet.
What'd you say?
It was 35 minutes. She took the over.
Yeah. Our next meeting in August.
September. Next meeting officially is September.
September.
We will have an August meeting if there's some sort of problem, but
okay.
And hopefully in person next year. It'd be nice to see you all in person a little more. So that'd be great.
Yeah.
Motion to adjourn.
It's like a spirit staring at the screen, right?
Yeah, I know. Be much better. Motion to adjourn.
Motion.
Second.
I'll second it.
All right. Roll call, second. Phil.
Yes.
Denise?
Yes.
Michael?
Yes.
And I vote to adjourn too. Thank you, everybody. Have a wonderful summer.